on to the high-level representatives, United Nations. I will start with Ms. Marie Paula, Director of the Office of UNESCO and representative to the United Nations. You have the floor.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Honorable Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor, a great pleasure, on behalf of Ms. Marie-Paule Roudil, representative of UNESCO to the United Nations, to be with you today at this important event that is highlighting indeed the key role of education for culture of peace for our societies. As we heard so many important interventions about national initiatives and efforts, UNESCO would like to welcome this mobilization of parliamentarians around the advancement of culture of peace. Peace is woven in the DNA of UNESCO, created in the aftermath of the World War II, a time when scars of vicious xenophobia and racism were all too fresh. Unfortunately, even 70 years later, we continue to witness the conflicts that rage across the world and tear societies apart. We continue to see violence and extremism sparkled by hatred and ignorance. And for UNESCO, education for human rights, culture of peace, and nonviolence enhances the quality of education and thus advances lasting peace and sustainable development. This is why our collective effort to promote education for culture of peace is so important. And today, more than ever, in every country and region, peace has to start in the benches of schools. As education goes to the very heart of international peace and security, access to quality, relevant education and lifelong learnings are indeed a sine qua non for countering all major challenges of our current societies. And here again, education can help create the conditions that make it difficult for violent extremist ideas to spread. It can strengthen learners' assistance to violent extremist messages. To this end, specifically, UNESCO supports the work of governments into educating world children and youth about culture of peace, and that means educating about the 21st century. It's all about education for skills for decent work and life. It is about education for values and behaviors for living in a world of diversity and change. Education for culture of peace and global citizenship is at the heart of Sustainable Development Goal 4, starting indeed in early childhood, and we've already heard some of the previous speakers referring to the importance of addressing young children as early as kindergarten. To this end, UNESCO works to strengthen education systems and support teachers and learners in preventing violent extremism through action in the classroom and beyond. So far, we have worked and organized various trainings in East and West Africa, Central Asia, Southeast Europe and South Asia, and we have worked to equip with tools and guidelines such as teachers and policy makers' guides on the prevention of violent extremism through education. UNESCO has provided a platform for policy dialogue through UNESCO forums on sustainable peace and education for sustainable development. With already three forums that have taken place, the first one in Bangkok in 2013, the second one in Paris in 2015, and the last one in Ottawa in 2017, these forums bring together stakeholders, groups, and experts from both fields of culture of peace education and education for sustainable development. The next forum will be held in 2019 and will focus on early childhood care and education interventions. A few examples of UNESCO's work in the field of countering violent extremism and promoting culture of peace are the following. Our Asia-Pacific Center of Education for International Understanding, located in the Republic of Korea, promotes and develops education for international understanding and global citizenship education through its various programs. In addition, the center hosts the Global Citizenship Education Clearinghouse, which contains a global database on global citizenship education to facilitate information sharing and enhance knowledge and understanding. UNESCO International Bureau of Education works specifically now on a project called Global Citizenship Education for Curriculum Development and Integration, and it targets pilot countries such as Cambodia, Colombia, Mongolia, and Uganda. This project covers a series of country activities relating to the situation analysis, policy dialogue on mainstreaming global citizenship and education systems and the curricula, as well as strengthening culture of peace curricula and teachers' training. Third, UNESCO Mahatma Gandhi Institute for Education for Peace and Sustainable Development, located in New Delhi, India, focuses on supporting member states to advance Target 4.7, notably the target aiming towards education for building peaceful and sustainable societies across the world by developing programs that promote socio-emotional learning, innovate digital pedagogies, and empower the youth. Last but not least, recognizing the importance to teach and learn about the history, and notably about the history of genocides and such as the Holocaust, and to fight all forms of discrimination, including anti-Semitism, to prevent new violence, UNESCO recently released guidelines for policymakers on addressing anti-Semitism through education, aim to reduce prejudice and promote tolerance through education. All our efforts are in cooperation with international partners, as complex issues such as violent extremism certainly requires coordinated action and joint efforts. For that, we are working with teachers who have struggled during the conflict and with those who have even stopped teaching by providing psychological support and tools for new pedagogies. Ladies and gentlemen, with these few words, I would like to finish by saying that we have to work together to build inclusive societies and achieve our common aspiration of sustained peace. And your work is more than ever important for that initiative, as it's only through collective commitment and actions that we can achieve these goals. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Marie.